Lion College will kick off to the Lions. Sagu leads this game 20-0, and we are underway in half number two at the four-yard line, up now to the 20. We got room. It's Carl Morgan.
Oh, flag.
There's a flag. It's going to come back near midfield. Carl Morgan, a good run back, but it's going to likely be whistled back.
Well, that was a lot of room running right there, but I think there might be a holding near the 35, and it is definitely coming back.
So will that be marked at the spot of the foul, or will it be marked?
Well, they'll do the penalty. They'll do the penalty from where the foul took place. So they'll back it up from the 35 on. Holding. Goodness.
Well, that's sometimes why those runs get sprung loose, is because someone held, but hate to see that. First play out of the box, a penalty. And they'll back it clear up to the 25-yard line, Brian.
Well, the good thing is there's 10 more yards to put in the stats for
when,
if they score here. Like I said, I've been pretty impressed with Lion College on defense. Just looking at the comparison and visually looking at the size between the D-line and offensive line, I am a run-oriented former head football coach. I'd be just running downhill on those guys right now. But
bubble pass
out
to...
Uh-oh, or just do this.
We got room. We got room. It's Pittman. Down the 25-yard line, dragged down near the 20. Xavier Pittman with a big, big, big catch. Yak, yards after catch on that one.
Huge slip screen right there. And like I said, don't listen to me because I have since retired from coaching. I know nothing. Just run the slip screen and get almost a touchdown on it. It was beautiful.
Wow. So... ball the 21-yard line. Collins in trouble.
Gets
it off, though, to Bickham. Slips forward.
Ricky
15,
Bobby 10.
He's going to go in the end zone. Touchdown, Lions! Ricky Bickham!
Wow. I thought for sure Collins was going to throw this away, but he was holding on to it just a second longer to throw that screen pass to Bickham. That's a beautiful play. I stand corrected. Don't run the football. Just throw it two times and get a touchdown.
30 seconds, two plays. 75 yards, capped by a 21-yard pass to Ricky Bickham. And the Lions are on the prowl again, wasting no time, getting on the board at the 14-18 mark. It is now 27-0 Lions. First, it was a nice little slip screen pass to Pittman. He did most of the damage, and the very next play looked like Collins may have been about to be sacked, but there was Bickham kind of waiting in the flats for it. Looks like almost a design play. Now, is that a play where the quarterback almost wants to be rushed?
He wants as many of the defensive front guys to come through, so
right.
He'll throw it over the top of him, and Collins is about 9 feet tall, so he's able to throw over him. What is he, about 6'3",
he's
4"?
Let's see here. Collins is 6'4". That's
right. So that's the type of quarterback you want when you run a screen like that, to be able to throw over the top of those defensive linemen. That was beautifully designed play by Coach Tristan.
We got some first half stats for you. First downs 14-6 in favor of the Lions. 119-49 yards advantage for the Lions on the ground. Passing yards, actually, the Lion College Scots out through the Sagu Lions, 82 yards to 76 yards.
Well, that's since changed.
Right, just now. Time of possession is huge in favor of the Lions in the first half. Sagu, 23-41, and just 12 minutes and 7 seconds for the Scots in the first half of play. Bowles. He's rushed for 41 yards. That's going to go through the end zone. Well, it'll be taken back at the 5.
Goodness.
No, he's going to take it out. He's going to come out with the 15.
Uh-oh.
Now to the 20, 25,
nice.
Down to the 30. I thought he was going to just let it run through. He took it about the 6 yards deep into the end zone. took it back out to the 30-yard line. Nice, nice return.
Well, that was very gutsy, and I'm sure his coaches are saying, great job. A lot of them, you probably heard him scream, no, and then he broke something, and he said, yes. So that was a nice run. They need something positive to happen on this drive, offensively, for sure.
Leading all rushers for the Lions was that Shaquille Jones with 38 yards on 5 attempts. Chris Jenkins, 33 on 8 attempts. Bickham, 32 on 5 attempts. So all within a few yards of each other.
Going downhill.
And here's
with
Bowles.
Big Bowles. Getting about 4 yards almost.
And he averaged 3.4 in the first half. That's about right. Right on cue. He had a long of 14. Passing, 4-12. Robinson for, like we said, 82 yards. And 53-yarder to Lucas Branscum early on in the first quarter. Meanwhile, Collins, 11-16 for 76 yards with two balls to Moncrief, and Pittman caught 3.
They don't have enough guys on the line, it doesn't look like. Now he's slowly coming up.
Eight other receivers have caught one ball.
That's beautiful.
Boy, Bowles.
Bowles is just trucking.
Head down and moving.
It's just smash mouth football straight ahead.
10 receivers caught a ball in the first half from Collins. 8 of them caught one.
Wow.
Moncrief, 2, and Pittman, 3. You talk about spreading
the workload
out.
Yeah, you can't just single one person out to guard. You got to guard them all.
So,
or cover. I said guard. I know you're getting excited. I said
basketball
term.
Basketball season. First and 10 at the 41-yard line. Bowles around right tackle and brought down by Carl Morgan, who came in from the secondary.
Bowles is going out for just a quick break here. But he impresses me. I tell you what, whenever these guys become juniors and seniors, if they can stay together, they're going to be a force to reckon with.
Well, Kirk Kelly's done it before with the baseball program, and there's no reason to think he can't do it in the football. He has football. He actually played college football as well. He didn't just play high school. He played in college, so he knows the game.
Another guy can run for them is Robinson. A little quarterback draw right there.
Mott on the stop. Devon Brown, number 90, checks back in. Number 2 in the nation in tackles for losses per game at 2.6. He's got 13. He had one earlier, so that makes it 14 now in the season for Devon Brown. Big number 90 there.
Well, this is definitely a big down for Lions College for sure. Shift a little bit on the momentum with a first down.
Man in motion. And he is not going to get it, Brian.
He's not, but
Bowles didn't make it.
If they send their punt team out, I would definitely be thinking about a fake here because they have really nothing to but an opportunity to do something positive. I think they might even think about going for it. Might as well right now. Fourth and 3 maybe, a short 3.
They're going to go for it. You're down 27-0. You really have, you know, the proverbial nothing to lose at this point.
Right.
And try to make something positive happen here to at least look at some good film this week.
Well,
yeah,
there
you
go.
Well, they could do that right there.
Middle
and I think they just got themselves a first down the easy way. Let Southwestern give it to them. It's going to be offsides against the Lions. That will give the Scots a first down and also put them into Lions territory.
Did we have a stat on penalties?
Yes, we did. I'll give them to you right now. Penalties, 3 for 19 yards for the Scots. And 5 for 52 yards for the Lions, and I know right where you're going.
Mercy.
Too many mental mistakes.
Yeah, that'll – I mean, when you're playing a team that you have to beat to win the division
– which is next week.
That will kill you.
Absolutely will. I cannot keep making – silly
mistakes.
There we go. There's a mistake by Robinson. He's going to have to just get rid of it out of bounds. Not a bad play by Robinson to salvage it. Would have been a huge sack.
Robinson's a pretty good athlete coming out of Palm Bay, Florida. Redshirt freshman. I tell you what, it is exciting to see so many young kids out there playing because in the future it's going to be pretty good.
Well, it's not just that city. I mentioned at the pregame show or early on in the game, that head coach Kurt Kellett was from Sarasota Riverview High School. There are three players on the roster playing from Sarasota Riverview High School who came all the way to Batesville, Arkansas to play for Kurt Kelly. So there's some kind of a gravy train between Sarasota and Batesville that's beginning to cook here for Lyon College. We'll see how that plays out. You've got a kid named Brian Liddy, Nick Bernier. You've called his name a couple of times. Nick Bernier's from, mm-hmm. from Sarasota, as well as a third player.
Well, we got
and I can't find his name right now.
We got third and seven right now, and they're opening it up a little bit with their formation, so Sagitt didn't have an opportunity to have so many people in the box.
David Knight, also from Sarasota, from Kirk Kelly's hometown.
Bet you they're going to put Sendo Bowles out. There you go, Robinson.
He's in trouble. He gets in trouble. He gets rid of the ball, though, just in time. Tackle by Ethan Eastwood.
Somebody's down out there. That's not good.
It is a Scots player.
Hopefully that's not Robinson.
I think
it might be.
I think that's Robinson. That is the starting quarterback, and he's not moving. And what makes it worse is he's laying face down. He's on his belly.
Well, the backup quarterback right now is getting his arm loose on the sideline.
Yes, he is. It sure is. Number seven, Tanner Stevenson, another redshirt freshman, Brian, 6'3". 210-pounder from Conway, Arkansas. Well, they do that. Let's ask you another trivia question, Brian. Do you know what year did Sagu football advance to the varsity level, outside the junior ranks, to the varsity level?
I do.
Collegiate level.
Do you know?
I do not know for sure. I think it's late 90s. Mm. It's got to be late 90s, so we'll think about that.
Right. Tweet it in if you know. Definitely.
I think I've narrowed it down in my mind. I could be wrong, though, but I think it's late 90s, somewhere mm-hmm. in there. Well, it is going to be number seven in the ballgame now. Tanner Stevenson, a redshirt freshman out of another Florida city, Brian, Bushnell, Florida, South Sumter High School. So there is something going on there in Florida.
Sure.
Want to come up and play for Coach Kurt Kelly. Let's see what this redshirt freshman can do. He's going to play from the shotgun here. His chance to make something happen. He's going to go to the air, lobs one up, and it's Shaquem Taylor again with the pick, almost exact replay of the very first play from scrimmage when the game began when Robinson threw one up for Taylor.
Well, that was just basically, he just threw it up there, and Shaquem jumped to the highest point and caught that ball because he's coached up to do, and another turnover, that's four. Unfortunately, interceptions. But like you said, it's fourth and long. You're down 27-0.
It's a punt.
It's basically a punt. So
Dalton Hillman was the intended receiver. So a punt that goes as an INT, that's the second of the day for Taylor. Little bubble screen pass down to the 20-yard line.
Defended pretty well there by Lyon College. They brought enough players to stop the initial slip screen, and they just tackled him for only a 2-yard gain, so not too bad. There's only one series at Lyon College hasn't just looked all that great, and that was last series when they got scored upon with two plays. But all in all, they've not just been steamrolled by any means.
Just can't say enough about Frank Tristan and his staff. Assistant coaches, including him. So
here comes corners.
Uh-oh, that's a live ball.
It's
a live ball.
Yep.
Lions fall on it.
Another corner blitz from the short side of the field. That's the second time they've done it this game. Short side of the field on his blind side. He doesn't even see it coming. Fantastic call on the short side of the field. That was a beautiful call.
Nine coaches total on the staff, including Tristan. A total, get this, before the season began, a total between nine men of 3 years of collegiate coaching experience.
Wow.
It is quite a big wow to see this team with a brand new coaching staff on the verge of going 5-1 and not ranked yet, but after this week, you may see them slip into the top 25. Collins will keep it himself.
Be careful.
Still on his feet. Be careful. Is right. 25-yard line.
Oh, my
up
goodness.
To the 30. He's got some room.
Big boys
he
trucking.
He might go all the way. He's got one man to beat. Cuts back. Spins around. Still on his feet. Watch him from behind. Down to the 10.
Holy cow.
5.
He might
get there. Oh, down to the 1-yard line. Are you kidding me? Finish it off, CJ. Come on, man. Come on.
His teammates are going to be all over him.
That ball was snapped from the 8-yard line. Do the quick math. Oh. 92 takeoff, 1 yard. A 91-yard scamper. And he doesn't score.
He doesn't score. He was rumbling, stumbling, but he didn't. He wasn't fumbling. That's good.
He held on to the ball.
I bet you they give him a chance to run it in here, man.
He just kept opening up space, kept cutting back, and there it was.
Nope.
Give the ball to CJ. Who is this guy? Chris Jenkins, you're not a running back compared to CJ right now. Well. Come on. Oh, CJ. Put it in. Now, CJ Jenkins just. How about the vision, the awareness to run 91 yards and not score?
So did he change his last
name? I know. I just gave him a new name. C.J. Jenkins. That's we went from Chris. Hey, well, Chris Jenkins. Yep. C.J. So there's my confusion. So, wow.
I think play action pass here. Nope. Hand the ball off.
It's going to be touchdown. Now there's Chris Jenkins. See, once I get the name right, he scores. Chris Jenkins punches it in. From 3 yards out. Wow.
Well, I know he's going to be getting some grief on when they watch film. he just plows through and gets in the touchdown. A little power football. People blocking down. People kick out, and he's just running up the middle. That's just phenomenal. This is how I thought the offense was going to look at the beginning of the game, and they're pulling it together in the second half, so that's good.
2 minutes, 41 seconds, 4 plays, 92 yards. PAT is good. It's 34 to zip. Lions in full control of this one.
And even though Lions College is getting beat pretty handily right now, I'm seeing those kids hustling on and off the field. There's no quit in them. They're freshmen. They realize they're going to persevere through this year more than likely. And they might, it's going to be better next year. But I'm telling you, when these kids are juniors, if they stay together, big old Bowles and Robinson, it's going to be a pretty formidable team to play against.
83-yard drive, even though it was 91 yards, it was the penalty and the loss of yards. So it was a 91-yard run by C.J. Collins, not C.J. Jenkins or whatever else I call those guys when I combine their names. Capped off then by a 3-yard run by Chris Jenkins has given the Lions 34-0 lead, and the crowd was on their feet. They loved it. We loved it. It just took forever him to get down that field, but he just kept cutting back and getting open. Great blockers were helping him out as well.
Yep. Well, we got Zach Chapman just came into the game on kickoff, came in from the sideline, replaced one of the players. Zach Chapman, in fact, I used to be the defensive coordinator, and that's why I remembered this.
What number is he?
He is number 92. I used to be the defensive coordinator at Tarkington High School right in the beginning of my career in Cleveland, Texas, and that's where Zach Chapman's from. 6'4", 220-pound. Recruit out of Tarkenton.
Yeah. Well, they're going to go take a knee. He thought twice about it.
Yep.
That was James Davis.
Well, the good thing now is, if Coach Tristan wanted to, maybe one more series with your starters, but it's time to start rolling in.
Absolutely.
Your backup guys. Protect your starters and give the young guys an opportunity to get some game time experience, because you never know when – your backup's going to end up being a starter.
That is a really good point, Brian. And the game is definitely out of reach
right now. Mm-hmm.
But boy, you did not want to see like a Andres Brewster or a Bickham or a CJ get hurt in any way in a game that's pretty much done. There's a tip, incomplete pass intended for Trip Reed.
Good defense right there. It went through his hands. It was a nice, hard pass. It should have been completed. It was an opportunity for another turnover. Thankfully for Lyon College, it wasn't. A two tight end set, one in the backfield. I'm thinking they might hand the ball off to Bowles. toss.
They toss it off instead. And Mott and company wrap up Bowles in a hurry. Jeremiah Mott, the senior from Slidell, Texas, leading the charge on that one. One of three starting linebackers for
Coach Tristan. Looks like Bowles is hobbling just a little bit. And it was, like we said in pregame, the number four rusher in NAIA versus the number five defense. And for sure, they're holding Bowles under 100 yards so far today. Third and long, got trip set over here to the left. Sprint out pass.
Robinson looks downfield, overthrows his man. Pass intended for number 29, Jansen Acklin. Good to see Robinson at least back in the game.
Definitely.
Bring up a punting situation. Now let's see what the Ortega Jones saga brings us this time. I'd like to see him actually catch a ball and actually run forward with it. Come on, Yvonne. Time that out right. He's a sophomore from Fort Worth, Texas, out of North Crowley High School. He stands at his 36-yard line. Little to no breeze in the punter's face.
Almost blocked.
And it's a short punt. It's
guys, get
right
away
near
from
midfield.
There you go.
It rolls out of bounds to 48-yard line. So Yvonne Ortega Jones, again, not a chance to redeem himself from that first little escapade back in the first quarter. 6:03 left in quarter number three, and we'll see if the Lions do indeed send out some of their second or third team units. Well, CJ's still out there, number 10. He's going to go out there and lead the troops, but let's see who else is coming back out there. We've got 27 back out. That is going to be Shaquille Jones back out, running back. You've got Jeremy Carr. He's been playing some. Shayla's still out there, Caleb Shelley.
That's a name we haven't called much today, if at all. I don't think we've...
Maybe caught one ball. I don't, think,
I don't know if he's even caught that. Might be time to get Shelley the ball.
Shaquille Jones, weak side, couple.
Yeah, very short game. I think now the sideline might be thinking about running, slowing it down just a little bit to use a little more clock.
Yeah. A staggered trip set on the bottom side for Collins and the pistol. Single set back behind him. He looks to pass, three-step drop, now in trouble. Scrambles, looks
there
at the head.
Is. There's
He's got
Shelley.
A man, Shelley, wide open.
Oh!
And he dropped it. Oh, he had his man, Shelley. Had two hands on it. You got to catch that ball, Mr. Garrison.
Mm.
Got to bring that one in. He's
that,
not
was
happy.
Was that Shelley or was that Luke?
Oh, it's Shelley.
Is it?
Caleb Shelley had that one hit. That's a sure-handed catch almost 99% of the time, but not this time. Here it is again.
Sprint out,
keeps
pass,
his eyes up.
Containment, and he
gets it up,
up
in the air.
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
Maybe the sun? I mean, I don't want to put excuses out there.
Shake it.
Well, we're looking at that play. It is Justin Allen.
Be smart, guys. Be smart.
And now flags are flying after the Allen catch and run. Dexter D's on the stop. Let's see which way this one goes. Yeah, Shelley had that one, had two hands on it. It's going to be against the Lions, and one of them is going to be against both offsetting penalties. So
I don't know.
We'll
what
see where they
here.
Move the ball.
I'm confused. They called two penalties on Sagu and one on Lyon College. So
Lions.
I wonder if they walk it off one way and walk it back the other way.
Well, they're walking.
They're walking
in
some
favor of Southwestern at this point.
Sure are.
Hmm.
Interesting. These referees, man, they got to know those rules because right now I'm taken aback on what's even being called here. We got illegal hands to the face. They pointed. Thought to Sagu, but it sure is not looking good. Oh, look at this bubble screen
nice
with the R2 spin.
Spin.
And he's running forward. That's old school,
yes,
R2.
It is.
All right. Then, so they walked it forward, and then they walked it back some. Looks like it's going to be, I don't know.
First down and First down and
first and
moving the chains now. Probably first and 10.
There we go.
At the 34-yard line.
How about our help up here in the booth? The ladies are doing great today.
Our statisticians, our floor managers. Mm-hmm. We got Lacey Sanders here, Caitlin Popelka. We've got Emily Chinchai. We had Josue Campos helping out for a while there. Thank you, folks, for all your help making us get information in a timely fashion. Got a great camera crew today working as well. Your homecoming weekend replay folks done by Mallory Lau and James Lex and his team of graphics artists. All right, we're back to live action here. Just about 5:10 left and ticking. CJ looking for more points, looking to pad them stats. Trip set up top in a staggered formation. CJ looks left,
there's
throws right.
Again.
Got Jones, shakes, dances down to the 30-yard line.
Pushed out of bounds by number 4. That's Steven Benedict. The short gain. I think CJ might have needed to hold on to the ball just a little bit longer for that screen to develop. I think he threw it just a little too quick.
Benedict, another Florida product from Panama City up in the Panhandle. Out of Arnold High School, playing for Lyon College. Bring up second down and 7. Trip set up top again. Collins from the pistol. Looks right, bubble screen. Shaquille Jones scoops it up. Nice catch by Jones. That was a tough ball to catch. And I want you to see, if we see it again, how Jones kept his eye, followed the ball right into his hands. Didn't look up ahead to see what was going on. Secured the ball first. With his eyes, watch his eyes, right, eyes down, right there. See what he did there, Brian? He just kept his chin down, eyes on the ball, then moved from there. Now he gets the ball again down to the 21-yard line.
Well, he's definitely a fundamentally sound football player, catching the ball earlier there and tucking it away and then just ran a nice run and protected the football, getting the first down.
I'm impressed by this kid's running ability and his pass-catching ability. And he's going to be vying for some more snaps here in this rushing-by-committee team that Tristan is developing.
The four-headed monster? I mean, that's what we're going to have to call it next time.
He's a sophomore.
Yep.
Up ahead to, nearly tipped and then caught anyway by Xavier Pittman. It was a tough catch, defended. And really, the defender got the first look at it, first crack at it.
That's
here
right.
It is again.
Right there to make a play, but
right off the
just not tall enough to make that interception.
Hawkins had a look at it, then it went off the head of Pittman.
That's a stretch play.
Here's Jones again.
He's all right.
Jason Ellis on the stop. 3:27 remaining. Bring up 3rd and 7.
3rd and 7. This
I'm going to call for Shelley again. It's time for Caleb Shelley to redeem himself from that last pass play. Pass in the flats.
Upfield.
Move upfield, going the wrong way. That pass is complete, though, to Jeremy Carr.
I think it is time for the All-American to go out there.
I think he lost a couple.
Here comes the All-American.
Here comes Mr. Deeren.
And that, again, is another time that Lyon College is holding them to small points. I mean, you obviously don't want people scoring, but imagine if Deeren hadn't kicked 2 field goals already, and if he makes this one, it'd be his 3rd one.
35-yarder, snaps down, kick is up, plenty of leg, and it is good. 35 yards out.
Would have been 21 points added on instead of just 9. Something that, you know, a coach has got to find the positives for a team when they're getting beat 37-0. And he can point that to his kids is, hey, you went against a stud offense in Sagu, and you were giving up field goals, yes, but you weren't giving up touchdowns. For a young team, something to hang their hat on.
3 minutes, 30 seconds, 10 plays, 43 yards, capped by a 35-yarder by Deeren has given the Lions of Southwestern a 37-0 lead, and I would like to see that shutout maintained. It may not happen, but That's a goal now within the game. The game itself is determined, but you want to see that defense pitch a shutout as they go on the road next week against Langston. And we'll try to get you scores for those games as they come in. But Langston looking to go to 1-0 in their first conference game of the season. They're 2-2 on the year right now.
Getting the crunk shake out there. Well, I thought they were. Darren's got to get his crew doing it just a little bit better than that. I like it every time Darren puts the ball down on the tee, jumps up really high, get those legs warmed up, ready to boom it. Do you think he's going to kick it in the end zone? Do you think the kids are going to have a chance to return it?
Ah, that's two back there at the 2-yard line. Here it comes. It's going to be taken right at the 1, out to the 15, the 20, met at the 20, and dropped down in a hurry. James Davis.
We got another flag out here. We got two flags. We got to be smart, guys. Come on now.
Scott scored 21 points in a loss to Tabor College game one, just 10 in a thrashing from Lindsey Wilson, 76-10. Scored just 7 in their third game in a loss to Hendricks, 42-7. And then a big loss against South Dakota, Mines and Technology, 51-10. But then, like you said in pregame, exploded for 35 points against Bacon in a nail biter, which they lost on the last play from scrimmage as Bacon scored a touchdown as time expired. So you can see Lions, the Lions Scots can put points on the board. But today it's been all Sagu Lions defense. They've held their own and kept Bowles at bay.
Definitely kept Bowles at bay. They've kept Robinson at bay. We're trying to figure out what the referee was saying. He's pointing Sagu way and he's pointing the other way. Looks like they might offset. They do. First down. First and 10 at the 20. They are chain games a little. Chain gang up top's just a little too tired to stretch them out right now. They've been working them to death. These poor guys out in the sun.
And next week, this Lion ball club, the Scots that is, goes on the road to Arizona, to Phoenix, to play Arizona Christian.
Good Lord, those guys have been all over the country, up in North Dakota and to Texas, to Arizona. They're all from Arkansas.
They have been.
They got a nice travel
a lot of
budget.
Places. Yeah, they need to get, put their frequent flyer mileage to use.
Say that real fast two times.
Frequent.
There's Bowles running downhill again, still trucking. He's not giving up.
No.
I like that.
Single setback in the eye. Under center now. Robinson pitches back.
Toss coming downhill.
To the A-gap. And the pile gets pushed forward to the 30-yard line. Tackle on the play by Paul Ellis.
All right. Yeah, there you go, teammate. You better hold Bowles up.
Big old number 75 there. That's a big boy, Jacob Lovelace. Oh, yeah, 325-pounder, a 6'5" beast out of Stockton, California. They need to stock up on some more food out there. In Stockton, my goodness, that's a big kid.
A big kid, and the recruiting these guys are doing from Lyon College, it's all over the nation also. It's very impressive.
He's a transfer from Sacramento City College up in Arkansas to play for Coach Kelly.
Well, he's getting them from Florida. He's getting them from California.
Sure.
He's got some from Texas.
Missouri.
Those are some big football states, and of course he's grabbing them from Arkansas.
Oh, absolutely. There's even a kid from Alaska.
There you go. I mean, if you're going to tackle a polar bear, you might be able to come out here and tackle a lion.
Peter Cott tackling them bears, playing now for the Lions. Mm-hmm. First down and 10.
Screen pass. Nice play.
Some daylight down to the 39-yard line.
Nice jailbreak screen right there where it looks like they could have thrown screen either way with the back running out and the backfield on the other side, and they throw the screen up top so the quarterback can read that. Those big old hog mollies out there, number 77, ready to run somebody over.
Elijah Pruitt on the stop, and you are seeing now the second team and third team defense, and Ortega Jones actually taking Shaquem Taylor's spot in cornerback on the left side.
Delayed draw right here. Be close.
Tackle from behind by number 93, Michael Umfenauer. He's also a second teamer. So I think you're right, Brian. It was about the time to bring in the second, third team, and that is exactly what Tristan's doing.
Fourth quarter time.
And we have reached the end of the third. Make sure you keep stay connected on all of our social media sites, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and you can check the highlights of this game and many other games on Facebook in the next couple of days. Our guys back at the shop do a great job of giving you all the details of the best plays from the weekend right here on the Sagu Sports Network.
Even using Periscope, huh?
I know. Mr. Cookman, he's just out there, man, innovating.
Well, I think
got the drone thing working too.
Oh yeah, I think Periscope's just about the coolest thing. I just got on that app here recently and figured it out, and it's pretty neat. It's a free app, and you can download and watch a lot of cool things that Sagu's putting out there on the social media, and it stays up. I think it stays up 24 hours, and it doesn't cost anything to download that app.
It's free.
Mm-hmm. And nothing better than free 93. All right, first down. We got Big Bowl still in there.
So your head coach, Tristan, you're 37-0. How do you keep your team motivated, although it's the second team? How do you keep the team itself just motivated to stay on their toes and play their best football when the game is obviously over?
Well, your second team guys, this is, to them, it's 0-0 right now because this is my first time to get out there on the field, so I'm going to show the coach my best, and I'm definitely going to show the coach that I need more playing time than the guy in front of me. So they're going to be giving them their best for sure.
Matt Williams on the stop. You're going to hear some other names now. They've definitely got pretty much everyone out who's starting. Although I do see number 90, Devon Brown, big number 90, still in the game for the Lions. 6'4", 265-pounder out of Richmond, Texas. Leads almost everybody in the nation. He's number 2 in tackles for losses coming into today's ball game. He's still out there. Lions look like they may be sending 5. They do send 5. And Robinson looks downfield and overthrows everybody. And it's going to be a late flag.
I can't call that.
Defensive penalty against the Lions. Pass interference looks to be the call, but was it catchable?
That was
holding.
Well, holding,
just
I guess.
Just a hold. I guess not so much interference, just a hold. So that should be 5 yards and a first down for the Scots. Yep. That'll put the ball just into Sagu Lions territory, the 47-yard line.
One thing for sure, these guys, Lion College, they are definitely wanting something positive. They want some points on the board going against the Sagu Lion team. It's clearly the better team, but these Lion College kids are not backing down whatsoever. They're battling and fighting out there and doing positive things.
Micah Wade has also checked into the game on the edge. Defensive end left side for the Lions.
They can get anything outside. It could be special or a very big play. Not special. It'd be a great play because Sagu is crowding the line of scrimmage. Want to try to attack the outside as fast as possible. I don't think they necessarily want to run the option with Robinson having a chance to get hit. But if they could get to the outside quick, it could be a big run play.
You've also got Paul Ellis out there. You've got, let's see, number 15's out there, Elijah Pruitt. We mentioned him a moment ago. So a lot of folks getting some playing time here. Second down and 8.
Quarterback draw.
He's going to keep it himself and gets met pretty hard at the 42-yard line. by number 46. That is Clay Trotter, another folk, another young man coming off the bench.
Yeah.
6 foot, 205 pounder from Mustang, Oklahoma.
Is he kin to Jeremiah Trotter, former linebacker for the Philadelphia Eagles?
We'll stick our James Lex on that one, so we can figure that out for you, Mr. Bryan.
Thank you.
James, get on that, please. Thank you. Third and five. Bryan wants to know stuff. Third and five.
Play action.
Going to keep it himself. Looks downfield. Now he's got a scramble. Devon Brown chasing him. And he stays on his feet. Loses a couple. I'll bring up third down and five.
Well, Robinson is, he's an athlete, and he didn't get many yards there at all, but he didn't get tackled for a loss, which shows you they have a bright future if they can keep these kids healthy and together, staying and not leaving and staying within the program. It could be something special here in the years to come.
Check that fourth down now, and they're going to go for it.
The referee's being nice during the clock.
47 yards, that's right. 47-yard line, fourth and 10. Lions send four. Now they send five. And through the hands of intended receiver at the 35-yard line, we'll turn the ball over on downs. Give it back to Sagu.
In and out of his hands, and still with 12 minutes, 36 seconds, still have the shutout.
Well, let's see if Collins, well, Collins is back out there in the huddle. He's going to stay in the game.
I hope he didn't run the ball at all.
Backup is Lincoln Kennitzer. He's a freshman, a 6'2 freshman out of Nashville, Tennessee. But it's going to be Collins. Torres Hill still in the ball game. You've got Chaz Moncrief in the ball game. Real quiet today has been number 8, Andres Brewster. No catches on the day. He's top set of your screen there. And a cornerback blitz.
Oh, goodness.
And he got it off. This could be a big play, folks.
Big, big.
Torres Hill. No, that's Moncrief. That cornerback almost lit up CJ from behind. And he got rid of it just in time to Moncrief. And a big gain down to the 30.
And that's why I cringed, because I definitely don't want to see him getting hit on the backside. Quick pass out. And, boy, he just gets up the field fast.
Yes, he does. Chaz has got some speed. Ball on the 31-yard line. Hand off.
Oh, Lord.
No,
please.
It's going to be a keeper.
Get on the ground.
He fooled me. CJ still on his feet. Twist, turns, angles down to the 12-yard line. Oof. A pickup of 19 yards.
Former football coach here is nervous. I don't want him to get hit. You're up 37 to nothing. Protect him. Don't let him get hit and hurt. Time of the day, so
CJ looking for six more. Oh, just over the outstretched hands of his intended receiver. I think that's Jenkins.
He was wide open.
It is.
Right,
was
in the back.
Tyler Jenkins.
Just a little overthrown.
Here it is nice again, Bryan.
Nice pass protection, and he just lobs it. Look at that beautiful spiral. Gosh. And the kid's only a sophomore. That's what fires me up.
Boy, going all out for that ball was Jenkins, though. Second down and 10 from the 13-yard line.
Jump
up in
ball.
The end zone, jump ball, no good. Headed for Torres Hill. Bring up third and 10. Little pick, play action there.
Pick up the ball for the referee guy. Come on. We got the guy with a big old camera on his shoulder. He's going to walk over and get the football. That was nice of him. Third and 10. Got trip set up top.
I kind of like the going back to Hill there in the bottom of your screen there, number 11, Torres Hill.
He's definitely got the height advantage.
Let's see if it goes right back to him or not. It's a pitch back over to Bickham. Cuts up down to the 5, the 4. Stopped right there. It's going to be real close for a first down, Bryan.
Ricky Bobby Bickham again tossing to the outside, and he's getting outside and shaking and baking and almost gets a first down. I bet you.
They're going to bring out Darren. They're going to be short, and they're going to bring out Darren.
How many has he kicked today? Is this going to be his fourth or fifth?
This will be one, two, three. This would be field goal number four if he's able to put it through.
Well, if he puts this through, I bet you he might have a chance to be player of the game, maybe.
That'll be spotted at the, call it the 12-yard line, so make a 22-yard field goal.
Sure, it's going to be hard for the coaches to choose who the player of
Low,
the game is.
But true it is. Deeren slams another one through, gives the Lions a 40-0 lead.
So if you're Coach Tristan, who do you pick as your player of the game?
Wow.
Go ahead.
Wow, I got to think about this.
Go ahead and call that out.
You've got, well, Deeren, he's got 1, 2, 3, 4 field goals plus the touchdown. So 1, 2, 3. Wow, he's got 15 points.
Right, right. And then you got to think about the secondary, all those interceptions they've
got. You've got Shaquem Taylor with two picks.
Mm-hmm. Might be multiple people.
You've got the kid Shaquille Jones has been a spark.
Yep.
Just from pure points, you got to go with, you know, either Collins or quarterback,
right,
or Deeren. But
right,
I'm kind of liking the shutout. I'm gonna go with the collective team, the secondary. With they've got four picks between the four of them.
Right.
Like I said, only Deontay Morrison has yet to get a pick. So I'm gonna say player of the game is going to be players of the game,
right,
and that is the secondary for the Lions. What are your thoughts?
I think it's going to be hard for Coach Deeren to choose because there's been so many great things that have happened today with Deeren and the secondary, and goodness, running back play, it's crazy. And I definitely won't say holy cow because that's craziness. Good stuff. Beautiful kick again from Deeren, the All-American, kicking it out of the end zone.
Wow, the big one.
That kid has got a monster leg. It's like Frankenstein kicking out there, booming them out the end zone. It's crazy. Holy cow, it's greatness.
He's actually got 16 points. He's got four PATs plus the four field goals. Yeah, 16 points. Remember the pick six. There was one defensive score.
Judah the Lion is getting crunked up on the track right
now.
Wow.
And, of course, the student is to remain a top secret. We don't know who the student is, but it is a current student who plays the role of Judah.
Nice run. Run downhill. Almost got 5 yards there.
I think we have a trivia question about the Lion of Judah. We may see that before the game's over. I heard someone say about their being a mascot trivia question, so we'll see if we've got that up for you for our local fans watching from the Waxahachie area. Or if you're an alumnus of the Sagu family watching today, you may get this trivia question right when it pops up. All right. It's going to be
goals
into first down territory.
Running downhill.
Near the 40.
Fast. Bounces just a little bit outside. Got about 7 yards.
It is again.
Look at him tuck that ball away, and he just lowers the boom on some people. Luckily, he was tackled near his thigh. He would have trucked through that kid for sure. Bowles has impressed me that he is still running full speed down 40-0. He has no quit in him. He might be edging close to 100.
About to check and see where he's at.
There's Robinson.
Robinson is going to keep it.
Uh-oh.
He's got...
Oh, no.
One man to beat.
Better dive. You better dive. Better. No.
Shutout's gone.
Shutout's gone.
Shutout is gone. And the Lions Scots are on the board. That is a, let's see, that's a 62-yard run.
And the kid is a freshman. And that's what I've been saying is when these freshmen figure it all out, they're going to be pretty formidable when they're juniors if they'll all stay together. That's an athlete out there with Robinson getting after it.
Impressive run.
Very nice for Lyon College to get something positive going there. That's something you can look at in the film and praise your kids for.
A minute 15 off the clock. Three plays, 80 yards. PAT is good. shutout gone, and with 9:27 left, scores 40-7, and a ray of light if you're on the Scots side of this field to see a kid like that fight back and run through all kinds of traffic. And just when he hit about the 30-yard line, he just outran. He got faster the further down the field he went, Brian.
And he didn't quit. And he hasn't. These kids have not laid down. They're battling through. They know they're going to lose this game, but they're fighting right now for pride. And
now, how can you tell that as a coach? You look at the body language. What are you looking for to tell me and our viewers that they've not quit and laid down?
And one thing that you'll notice in what I watch are the little things, like watching kids run to and from the huddle, watching kids run to and from the sideline. All right, something bad just happened to me. I get up, I run back to my huddle, and I come back and give it my all the next play. And you could see Robinson, and their studs are Robinson and Bowles, for sure.
Okay, here it is. Why did Sagu choose the Lion, to be their mascot? There it is, folks. If you know the answer, hit us up on Twitter, Sagu Sports Net Work, and give us your answer. Okay, you ask a question about rushing. Let's take a look at Bowles. He is at 80 yards, 24 attempts, averaging 3.3 a rush.
Yep.
And taken at the three.
Here come
the Lions. It's Morgan. Got a seam. 30, cuts back up. Still on his feet. Dragged down. Pushed down at the 38-yard line. Picked up 36 yards on that return. Dwayne Robinson, with that long run, almost has caught up with Bowles. He's got 68 yards rushing on 5 attempts. Meanwhile, for the Lions rushing, your leading rusher is C.J. Collins with that long run a moment ago. His average long of 91 yards. He's got 118 yards rushing. Next to him would be Shaquille Jones with 48, Ricky Bickham 41, and Chris Jenkins 34, Jenkins with the touchdown. Screen pass. I think that's to Vanique Benton, former high school quarterback standout right here on this field in Waxahachie High School. It is Vanique Benton, and he gets a first down and show why he is an athlete who belongs on this field. I'd like to see him on this field more often. This is home field. Let him play.
Exactly. Nice bubble screen there, and he gets outside. I wonder how many times on this field he's gotten first downs in his life.
It's the first time we've seen Benton on the field all day, and he is an outstanding athlete. He threw for a touchdown last year on a bubble screen pass, stopped and threw it downfield himself on a long play last year. And this time it's going to be
Number four.
I'm looking to see who that is.
We don't have a number four on the roster.
Who?
I look like number four.
Confused.
I could be wrong. Well, whoever it is, he didn't a heck of a play there. It's not
number four. We don't have a number four, folks, so we're going to try to just get that for you as soon as possible. But he's the quarterback in for,
oh boy,
for CJ. Oh, boy. How about that Xbox move right there? It didn't work out, but I liked the attempt by Chris Jenkins.
And if you'll look at the very end of that play, how many white shirts were around to make that play? That's another example of
them not giving
seeing
up.
A kid not
sure.
giving up.
Sure. Very good.
And that's what you want to see as a coach. And in an adverse situation right now, which it is, 40-7, I want to see how my kids are going
to
fight.
Okay, Lincoln Kinister has moved from number two to number four. So we had the backup name correctly, but he has apparently changed jerseys because Mo Montserrat wears number two. And so Kinister is at number four.
He's coming downhill. He
today.
Run a
there
little
he
bit.
Is.
Look
little
at that.
Skip, little skip and jump down to the 32-yard line.
Nice.
For Lincoln Kinister. He is a 200-pound freshman out of Nashville, Tennessee, at a Beach High School.
It's tackled by Jason Ellis.
Okay, here's our answer. Why did Sagu choose the Lion? Well, VP George Brazel acquired a four-month-old Lion cub, a real cub, and they named him Judah way back in 1963. The name stuck. the Lion hung around for as long as they could until it got too big and too dangerous. And they made Brazel get rid of it. But the name stuck and the mascot stuck. And so we became the Southwestern, the Summers of God University Lions. Thank you, George Brazel. 6:30 remaining in your ball game. Lions lose the shutout, but we'll gain the win. They will advance to 5-1 as they are now passing the halfway point of the season. Just 4 games left. Big one next week on the road in Oklahoma. And here's Kinister, a head down, head full of steam, gets down to the 21-yard line. Good enough for another Lions first down.
It's just his own read right there. He could have handed out off and giving it to him outside, but he comes downhill, and he is running with authority. Beautiful run.
On that zone read, you could give it to the running back. You keep it yourself.
Good.
He chose to keep it himself.
Yep.
And Lions are on the prowl again, wanting to add some second-team offensive touchdowns here. He does the same thing again, keeps it himself, gets not much there, pulled it out of Shaquille Jones's breadbasket, kept it himself, and pickups maybe one.
Well, it's good to see some of these backups get an opportunity to get in there and
absolutely
and get some playing time.
25 first downs now for the Lions, just 10 for the Scots. 269 yards on the ground for Sagu, 156 for the Scots. Passing yards, just 89 for CJ today. Kinister, head down to the 14-yard line.
He's coming downhill, putting his shoulder pads in front of him and running hard.
Just 18 yards passing for the Scots. Not much in the air at all. Penalties, pretty even now. Brian, 6 for each side, 52 yards for Sagu and 46 against the Scots.
Toss play, get outside.
Still on his feet, down to the 10, 11-yard line.
That is first down.
Levi Derry. He had a touchdown back in the second quarter, a 12-yard pass from CJ. That gave the Lions a 13-0 lead. He's back in the game.
Since we've been watching them here at home, there's been more than just 4 running backs. I think there's 5 maybe.
We've got
5 that have touched the ball. Maybe not today.
Chris
but,
Jenkins.
Right.
Bickham, mm-hmm. Seaton,
yeah.
Smith, Shaquille Jones, and J.P. Lowry. That's 6 running backs we've called names for this season. And here comes Derry again as he dives into the end zone. Is he going to get there? They're going to spot him at the half-yard line.
Just short.
Derry looking for touchdown number 2. Almost gets in.
Getting outside. He's protecting that ball on that outside arm, which is good. 2 hands on the ball right there. He's got good coaches coaching him up. I don't know if he didn't get it across. But I bet you he gets an opportunity to get it across here.
Or it could be Kinister on the keeper with
3:33
left.
It could be Kinister because that might be something he needs to be able to spark him to push Collins for maybe some playing time and make Collins better.
Vinique Benton wide out on the left-hand side. And it's going to be Derry. I think he's crossed the line.
No, they're not going to
get that. No, they did not. Short. He's still short. That'll bring up 3rd down and 1. Here it is again, Brian. Let's see how close
getting
he
downhill.
Got.
Hill.
It's so hard to tell
barely.
Right there. Yeah, he's going to be
a little short.
Still half a yard short.
I think they may have pulled him out.
And that there time, there's touchdown Lions. It's Shaquille Jones. Punches it in from 1 yard out.
Straight ahead running that lead. He's protecting it with 2 hands. Crosses the goal
line. There.
Keeps running just in case the referee thinks he's getting pushed back. Nice touchdown.
So the Lions inch their lead back up to 40, pending the PAT. It is a 61-yard drive that covered 12 plays. And the Lions have a 47-7 lead, capped by a 1-yard touchdown run, a half yard, we'll call it one, by Shaquille Jones, who's quarterback number 6 that we've called this year.
Wow, that's crazy.
Him and Derry.
The six-headed running back. We can no longer say.
I stand corrected. It's 7.
7-headed running back.
Derry, 1. Jenkins, 2. Your boy, Bobby Bickham, 3. Michael Seaton, 4. Been quiet today. Eric Smith, 5. Shaquille Jones, 6. And a great running back we'll see more of in the years ahead, J.P. Lowry. That's 7 running backs.
Holy cow.
That Tristan just, flip a coin, say, you know, rock, paper, scissors, who do we send in next? They all run same. They all do very well.
Yep. Well, that, and the good thing is, this having so many talented kids is competition makes every athlete better. So
sure.
If there's 6 guys that you can depend on, each one of those guys is doing their absolute best every single day in practice to impress their coach so they can get more playing time.
Well, hate to say I told you so, folks, but I told my friends here at the Psycho Sports Network my prediction of my score before the game began, and I'm pretty close right now. I predicted 44-3 in favor of Sagu. Right now we're looking at 47-7. Not too bad.
Not too bad at all.
For the old.
But unfortunately, before the
game.
The
old Mr. Price.
Before the game, I picked 47-7.
You just wrote that down.
Did you see me write it down?
He just wrote that.
You didn't see
Come
me
on.
Write that down.
Caitlin Lacy, did you just see? He just wrote this down. He
they
just wrote down 47-7. Come on, man.
So, you were off, but I was dead on for some reason.
I want my field reporter, Adam Ferguson, to be aware of my prediction, 44-3, because he questioned it. After game, we'll have a talk with head coach Frank Tristan, as his team will improve to 5-1. Be careful now. Get back on the field here. 57 gets in place just in time before the snap.
It's your time to get on the field, Bubba.
You're going to get on the field.
There's another chance.
A lame duck. He goes out of bounds. Who was that running on the field? That was number 57, Nathan Gordon. Get yourself out there. The freshman from Meridian, Mississippi, ran from Mississippi to get there just in time before the snap went off.
Well, also, you're seeing some backups in the game. Cody Jones is a quarterback now for Lyon College.
Right.
I think they've conceded that Bowles is not going to get his 100 yards rushing. They just want to keep him safe and healthy the last few minutes of the game.
And there's a little pitch back. Nothing there. Lions snuff that one out.
Slowly get up. All right, get up there, buddy. Well, it's fun to see each kid get an opportunity to get out there and enjoy this. There's not many people and many people in the world that can say they played college football and they actually got out there and had game time. So that's neat that these kids are getting that opportunity for sure.
Looking ahead for Lions, we talked about them going to Lankson next week on the road. And then you've got Wayland Baptist here at home. We'll have that game for you here on the Sagu Sports Network at 2 p.m. call October 24th.
You know, they got Robinson out there right now. Robinson's at receiver. They just threw the ball to him.
Instead of
playing quarterback, he's out there at receiver now.
Sure did.
He's
catching balls now.
Another athlete to maybe look at in the future is spreading the ball out. He can go do that.
He's in the middle of a trip set on the bottom of your screen right now at the pink towel. And pass incomplete underneath, intended for Trent Webb. Back to the Lions schedule. After our next broadcast on the 24th, Wayland Baptist, the Lions will be back on the road again, a long way on the road, way out to west in Phoenix, as they will go on the road against Arizona Christian, and finally at home against Bacon to wrap up the season on November 14th at 2 p.m. kickoff there. Langston could be a win. Wayland Baptist is not easy to beat at home. Will there be an advantage? But that is a good ball club there. Arizona Christian, a new program, but they'll be, you know, anytime you go on the road like that, it gets a new team, you don't expect. Bay Cone should be a win. So the Lions winning today should have at least 6 wins by the end of the season, maybe 7, 8, 9 wins, possibly. Meanwhile, on the field,
oh no,
there's a rush up ahead.
Get up.
I think that is that Jenkins again? Dane Macklin back on his feet. Lions could easily pick up 8, 9 wins here. If they beat Langston and Wayland Baptist, they could run the table here and finish the season at 9-1.
Then I hear they're going to pay for you and I to go on the road and
broadcast
the playoffs.
Playoff game. Let's do it.
That's what I hear. Get a nice traveling allowance. And everything.
I would like to see the Lions, I think they, after this game, I think they deserve it, to be nationally ranked. They're not in the top 25 poll as of this week, although they have a 4-1 record. But after this game and the score of this game, if you're the pollsters, you have to look at Sagu to be in your top 25, pending, of course, losses by the teams ahead of them. I get that. And that'll be a knee, and that should take one more snap in this ball game.
I'm going to give a quick shout-out to left tackle out there for Sagu. Christian Castro is a kid I coached in Midlothian, who is a freshman now for Sagu playing. I coached him, oh, goodness, about 4 or 5 years ago. A great kid.
Good kid.
Great kid.
So the Lions will watch the clock tick off. 15 seconds left. Lions will improve to 5-1 on the season. Congratulations to head coach Frank Tristan and his staff, giving the homecoming crowd a nice big win as you hear them cheering on their feet, thankful for another great win by the Lions. Everyone's healthy on their feet, walking to shake hands with the Scots. And that'll do it right there. Your final score, 47-7 in favor of the home team today. Your thoughts on how the offense looked overall? Wasn't the toughest team, but some things you liked, some things you didn't like today from the offense, Brian.
Well, one thing I liked for sure is how they could spread the wealth around, throwing the football. You said they threw to 10 different receivers, I believe, if not more. And also, goodness, there's a 6-headed running back threat that Sagu has. So that was very impressive. The thing is if you're a defensive coordinator right now looking at Sagu, there are too many threats at different positions to be able to plan on your game plan.
13 different receivers today, Brian.
That's crazy.
It is. It's amazing. And CJ ends up being the leading rusher as well with 118 yards. He throws for just 89 yards but had a really high completion rate, 20 out of 29. Had that long of 53. Levi Derry had a touchdown. Let's walk through the scoring again as you see the players shake hands. It began at first quarter, 5:41. A 12-play, 70-yard drive, capped by a 45-yard field goal by Darren. Sagu leads 3-0. 6 seconds left, first quarter, 10-play drive, 78 yards. It's another field goal, a 47-yarder with plenty of leg. Darren, again, lines up 6-0. Second quarter, 12:18 left, 3 plays, 18 yards. A 12-yard pass to Levi Derry, a new running back for the Lions. Sagu leads 13-0. And then to cap things off in the second half, first half it was 10:45 left, 1 play. It was the pick 6 from Carl Morgan. Sagu leads 20-0. And right now we'll pick up the second half scoring, but first let's go down to the field and check in with Adam, who's standing by with winning head coach Frank Tristan. Adam?
Thanks, Rob. I'm here with head coach Frank Tristan. Now, coach, 5-1, 1-1 away from tying the record for wins here at Sagu. What's that mean to you as a first-year head coach here?
Oh, that's outstanding. But, you know, really our guys have stayed here for 4 years. We've got 16 seniors, and then Coach Gonning's laid such a good foundation. So, I mean, it's just we're just enjoying competing every week. So, I mean, that's great, but it's great for our seniors. That's really awesome.
The story of this game was Sagu's defense, whether or not it would be able to hold its own against the Lion rushing attack, and it did that and then some, forcing 5 turnovers, a lot of interceptions. What do you have to say about your defense here today?
Our DBs were all over the field. They made plays on the ball, but Coach Gretsch does that. They work on making plays on the football, and it paid off for us. Their running back's really good, and he brought a load every time he ran the ball. He just did a good job, and fortunately, we were able to hold on, so it was good.
on the road next week against Langston. How do you feel? Probably the biggest game so far of your head coaching career in the season. How do you feel next week?
Well, we're prepared like it's every other game, you know, and it'll be fun. The kids will be really excited about playing it, and it'll be fun. They always have a good atmosphere and a good crowd, so we'll give it our best.
All right, Coach, good game. Good luck next week. Back to you, Rob.
So, yeah, you heard Coach Tristan say the same thing. Really impressed with the cornerback safety plays of Mark McCormick, Carl Morgan with the pick six, two picks by Shaquem Taylor. Didn't call Deontay's name a lot, but he played well also for the Lions. Second half scoring, Brian, we had at 14-18, a two-play 75-yard drive capped by that 21-yard pass to Ricky Bickham. Sagu leads 27-0. Third quarter, 7:04 left, four plays, 83 yards, the three-yard rush by Chris Jenkins, but really it was a 91-yard rush by C.J. Jenkins. Lions up 34-0.
C.J. Jenkins.
I did it again. Let's go C.J. Collins.
Okay.
I like that better. Third quarter, 2:30 remaining, 10 plays, 43 yards, 35-yard field goal by Darren. Lions up 37-0. Fourth quarter, 10:48 left, six plays, 53 yards. Another field goal by Darren, 22 yards out. Lions up 40-0. We were talking shutout. Let's get the shutout for them. But no, at 9:27 left, the Scots strike, three plays, 80 yards, capped by a 62-yard rush by Dwayne Robinson, 47. And finally, you said that one-yard run by Shaquille Jones with 2:43 left in the game, 12 plays, 61 yards. Final score, 47-7. So updated standings. Brian, walk us through these teams here in the CSFL.
Well, we got Sagu leading the pack right now, 2-0, followed by Arizona Christian and Bacone. And then everybody coming in from behind is Wayland Baptist and Texas College and Lyon College. But Langston, I believe today started conference play. One thing I want to say real quick is I got to visit with Coach Tristan last Friday night at the Midlothian football game. He was on the sideline.
Yeah.
And I was having a little game duty since I'm an assistant principal now. And I visited with him. He is such a humble man. And what a man of character to continue to praise Coach Godding and the foundation he laid with these seniors. And he's always pointing to somebody else and never taking the credit. So what a fantastic guy leading this program.
Went to one of our sister schools, Evangel, brought Paul Hansen with him, a former fellow teammate at Evangel, and just like to see that attitude transferred from a winning program in Missouri down here, and he's definitely on the way to doing that. Godding's our AD, does a great job up there. Running all the sports, and this sport is on fire right now. The Lions are 5-1. They go on the road next week to Langston. We'll be back here in 2 weeks here on the Sagu Sports Network on October 24th at 2 p.m. versus Wayland Baptist. I think I'll wrap it up here. Brian, final thoughts on this Lions win?
Looking forward to a great season. I'm looking forward to them finishing it off next week in Langston and then moving on towards coming back home.
All right. Well, for my partner Brian Garrison, my director John Cookman, and my field reporter Adam Ferguson, and all our amazing camera operators and tech crew, and a great homecoming weekend, the Lions take care of business 47-7. This is Rob Price saying so long from Lumpkin Stadium. Your final score 47-7. Until next time, may the Lord bless you and keep you and give you his peace.